What? Oh, come on, come on.
Struggling to keep your grass green? Maybe it's time you got a fertilizer that works at every level. Introducing Bayer Advanced Triple Action Lawn Fertilizer. It works at every level. The grass, the roots, plus it fortifies the soil for a thicker, deep-down green that lasts. Guaranteed. Bayer Advanced. Better thinking, better results. Prevent crabgrass while you feed. Try Triple Action Lawn Fertilizer plus Crabgrass Preventer.
Tonight at 8 p.m., brace yourself for storm stories. See the destructive force of a mudslide.
Go, go, go!
Watch a new series from the Weather Channel. Storm Stories, tonight at 8 Eastern and Pacific.
There's more from the Weather Channel at weather.com. More travel updates. More ski and snow conditions. More forecasts. At work or whenever you're on the web. Get more at weather.com or AOL keyword weather.
Storm Stories, tonight at 8 on the Weather Channel. And now, here's your local on the 8s. Currently, the temperature is 25 degrees with light snow. Extended forecast.
You're watching the Weather Channel. Live by it.
Yet another snowstorm moving through the Northeast. This one a very quick mover, but places like Boston and Providence still getting hit hard. We'll have all the details and an expert analysis in a moment.
And early morning commuters in Atlanta were facing all kinds of wet weather. Are drier conditions in your forecast? That's coming up. Hello and welcome to Weather Center. I'm Janetta Jones.
And I'm Jeff Morrow. Thanks so much for joining us today. Well, indeed, our top story today has to be the snowstorm in the Northeast, moving very, very quickly, and that may be the only thing that keeps snowfall totals down a bit across parts of southern New England. And here with some expert analysis on this storm and how fast it's moving and how much we're going to get, let's go to Paul Cosen.
Yeah, Jeff, it's actually a good thing that this storm is moving as quickly as it is. Snowfall rates are very high. When the snow comes down, it comes down hard, but it only lasts for a few hours, which is the good news. Snow beginning to taper off right now in the New York area. We'll be doing that later. We have what's known as a classic comma-shaped cloud on the satellite picture, and that's formed by two different branches of the jet stream, one southern branch of the jet, one northern branch of the jet, and often when we see that jet stream pattern, it's the area right in the middle that gets the heavy snow, and that's exactly what we're seeing today. Right at the base of that comma head, that's where we're seeing most of the rising motion, and that's causing the heavy snow across extreme southern New England. Now, if we just look at the radar bands, and remember all the greens here represent mostly frozen precipitation, in this case snow. We could see that the New York area within the last hour and a half has cleared out dramatically. There's still just some light snow coming into the north, but most of the significant snow has moved out towards the northeast, and we'll see a rapidly clearing pattern as well. Still some stray bands of some significant snow and freezing rain and sleet just south of the city. Those will seem to pass just south of the city. Even what we're seeing across Boston, within the last hour, we've seen this very, very heavy snow band. Originally, there was even some lightning and thunder across northern Connecticut. That seems to be also diminishing somewhat, although some of the heaviest snows still in the Boston metropolitan area. And we're also starting to see the back edge come to the southern portion of the region as well. So fast moving is going to be the word here. But before that ending occurs, all of these dark greens represent some very, very heavy snow. Visibility is down to a half to a quarter mile and possibly even less than that. So total snowfall accumulations in that area will be confined to about 6 to 10 inches of snow just to the north of New York City. Looks like in the city itself, 2 to 3 inches. Just heard an analysis that up 4 inches of snow on the north shore of Nassau County, up to a half foot on Suffolk County as well, but up to 6, 8, possibly even 10 inches in areas around southern New England, around Hartford, Providence, and anywhere from Boston south through Cape Cod. Another, unfortunately, big snowstorm for you. It will be out of there. A cold night ahead, Jeff.
All right. Thank you very much, Paul Kosin, our winter weather expert. Let's check out some of those snowfall tallies. That's in Pennsylvania and Jersey. LaGuardia, 2 inches. This was as of 1 p.m. and Central Park about 1.2. Probably ended up with around or close to 2 inches there. So again, as Paul just mentioned, this storm very rapidly starting to get out of the way. Still some leftover snow back up across upstate New York, and again, the tail end of it pretty much back here toward Wilkes-Barre, Scranton, generally from I-80 and PA north, but even that's going to be ending very, very quickly. Temperature-wise, 30 in Philly, still above freezing. This has been a rainstorm in D.C. at 39, 26 in the Steel City of Pittsburgh, and with the snow flying in Boston, it's 24. As Paul mentioned, a cold night tonight, a chilly start tomorrow, but hey, warming up a little bit, 37 in New York City, 48 in Pittsburgh, not bad. Let's head south now. Here's Janetta.
And here's where we've seen quite a bit of rain. Now, going to see a few more showers and thunder showers before all is said and done, as that front is going to get hung up here and sort of stall out. We've seen plenty of rain in the Atlanta metro area overnight. Big storms went on through. And now the front is starting to settle a little farther south of Atlanta, as we're expecting that possibility of more showers and thunderstorms south of the front. Well, you can see that dividing line, can't you? 35 in Nashville, Tennessee, 87 in Orlando. It's like summertime, huh? As we check out the forecast, we're expecting a little bit more in the way of scattered showers and thunder showers. Savannah, Hilton Head, Charleston, back down towards Jacksonville as we get through tomorrow morning. And tomorrow afternoon, staying a little bit on the wet side along the Gulf Coast, but warming up in Dallas and Memphis. Now here's Jeff.
All right, let's head to the upper Midwest and see how things are shaping up there. Fairly quiet today. We do have a little bit of a low, little clipper-type system with another batch of cold Arctic air behind it, trying to move out into the Dakotas, a little starved for moisture. But we may see a little bit of light snow, particularly up toward the Canadian border as we head into this evening. Definitely cold air. I mean, look at Bismarck, 10. Williston, 2. And it's not going to get much warmer than that. 26 in Chicago with a wind chill of 18. Only feels like 9 in Minneapolis and St. Paul. Some of that cold, cold Arctic air is going to be spilling east, but out ahead of it tomorrow, looks like we'll warm up a bit in Omaha, Kansas City, and St. Louis. A little early taste of spring. I think we'll take it. Now let's head west. Here's Janetta.
And here's where we're talking about a lot of snow. Nothing like springtime snow to get you into the mood for some skiing in the Cascades and even into the Bitterroot chain. That's where we've got our colder air mass rushing down from Canada. So it's very cold, rather breezy, and very snowy too. All kinds of winter weather advisories and watches and warnings in effect. And as we check this out, we can tell you that some locations will get over a foot of snow. Others, probably about 3 to 6 inches of snow in the southern Cascades and right on down towards Jackson Hole, Wyoming. Temperatures above that front, only in the single digits in the sub-zero category right now in Cutbank. Is it going to get any warmer in our forecast? Stay tuned. We'll tell you all about that and much more next.
Refinancing your mortgage is fast and easy with DITECH.com.
At DITECH, we refinanced our home at a lower interest rate, and we also took out an equity line of credit to have available for future use, and we were very, very happy.
If you're thinking about refinancing your mortgage, call or log on to DITECH.com for today's low fixed rate.
I would highly recommend Ditech to others because the process was so quick and easy and the people were great.
Ditech.com. Call 1-800-71-FIXED.
There's a ritual to eating lobster during Lobster Fest. Get a group of friends and family, gather around the table at Red Lobster, and begin cracking, dipping, and grabbing. Don't be afraid to pounce without warning. Butter on your shirt's not a stain, it's a medal of honor. Because you're not just eating food, you're eating lobster. So come to Red Lobster and try one of our amazing new lobster dishes. Lobster Fest, right now at Red Lobster.
Come in today for Red Lobster's Lobster Fest.
Introducing a moisturizing shampoo that won't weigh hair down. A shampoo that won't leave it lifeless. A shampoo with weightless moisturizers that go to the center of each strand, while the extra washes clean away. Moisture and lift, the best of both worlds. Shampoos and conditioners with weightless moisturizers. New from Dove.
Why make X-Lax your milk?